Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Jesse Warden here. Today we're going to talk about partial right. In our last video, we're drawing our code using partial left or partial. We created pure functions that defined their dependencies, so they're pure. They didn't use closures to magically import them. They clearly define those dependencies in the function parameters. You'll notice, though, that the known stuff is off to the left, and the dynamic stuff's off to the right. Unfortunately, a lot of times you're going to get functions where the dynamic stuff is first because the developer who wrote the function thinks that that's what you want. You're going to have to deal with those functions. Sometimes they're just third-party libraries that you can't modify. They're in your node modules. There's nothing you can do. So for that, we're going to use partial right. So let's show you an example. Right now, our JSON, when we load these two web services, it shows us some JSON. And that's fine, but we can make it nice and prettier, especially in Node. We're going to go ahead and import the util from util. And if you don't know, it has a nice little function called inspect. It's kind of like console log, but it gives you a really nice, pretty JSON. So we're going to go ahead and import this function here and use it. We're going to blast it on the result here so you can see what it looks like. I'm going to go ahead and put it right here, util inspect result. And we're going to put a depth of 2. And colors of true, so it'll make it nice and pretty. And it's just going to do it for the time so you can compare and contrast. So you'll see that numbers come in as yellow, the strings come in as green, and if you had a date object in here, it would actually be purple. So this is nice. It's formatted a lot better than the weather, and it's a little more contrast so you can read. So we're going to do the same thing here to the weather, and when we run it, we get our time nice and formatted and our weather as well. So a lot more easier to read and digest. However, you'll notice that this hard codes the result and it makes it difficult for us to copy and paste the same config. I actually paused this video as I fixed this because I broke this a couple times. You'll notice that the known thing, the config you want to use every single where else, is off to the right, but the dynamic stuff is on the left. So that's where partial right comes in handy. So let's go ahead and copy pasta. Actually, for right now, we're going to cut code for the win. That doesn't really have the ring to it, does it? I'm going to put this guy up top, and we're going to make him a pure function. So we're going to say const inspect, yo, take this partial right and apply it to inspect, okay? But the argument that we want to apply to the right is our nice little object. So if you look at this, imagine it's basically the same thing as inspect, yo. We're going to take O and call util inspect with the O and then our known object configuration off to the right. So the difference is that this is kind of pulling that from a closure up there where this is a pure function where it takes two inputs, right, directly that we apply at runtime. So there's no globals. It's nice and pure. But basically, they have about the same functionality. The difference is that we can apply this O where we want here by wrapping it. Where up here, partial right says, go ahead, I'll start from the right and prefill these parameters that you pass in the array. We're only passing one, so it's going to appear right on the right side here, which means that we can go ahead and use inspectio, and whatever we pass in is automatically going to be put in the holes, in this case, in the front or the left. So we inject it in here, inspectio result, delete this guy, down to the blue, inspectio result. Now when we run, you get the same thing nicely and formatted, but we have this nice little pure function up here. It's reusable. We don't have to duplicate this configuration because it's a known thing, very similar to the request module. It's a known thing, and we're going to go ahead and keep the request get function everywhere, right? Always giving it the request module because we imported it up here. It's a known thing. Just like util inspect, we always know it's going to use that object. So we can inspect these JSON objects or any object really in JavaScript. So that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you use partial right when your functions aren't created to have the known stuff to the left and the dynamic stuff to the right. You can use partial right to start from the right instead of the left.